Today marks the 37th Mardi Gras Parade in Sydney, and these days it is a fabulous, flamboyant and fearless annual event where we celebrate the lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender and intersex community. But for all the progress that's been made over the past few decades, Australia is seriously lacking in marriage equality. For more on this subject, we are joined by politician and sister of Tony Abbott, Christine Forster, and from Canberra, Senator Penny Wong. Welcome to you both. Christine, you've now been engaged to your partner of 8 years, Virginia.
Yep.
Is that right, 8 years?
7 years.
7 years, wow, time flies. 7 year itch is coming up. Surely you must be...
I hope not. We'll see how it's
way, in a good way.
But it's a long engagement,
well, maybe she's got it already, I don't know. She hasn't told me about it.
It must be frustrating that you still cannot legally marry here in your own country when it's happening progressively all over the world.
Oh, of course it is. And we said when we got engaged that we were quite clear about the fact that we wanted to be able to get married here in our hometown, Sydney. Mm-hmm. I'm very much, you know, I'm a councillor on the City of Sydney, so I feel very much that Sydney is my hometown and we want to get married here amongst our family and friends. Unfortunately, there hasn't been much movement on that. You know, there is a prospect of a private members bill being put before the federal parliament, and then there will be a debate, I guess.
How optimistic are you, given that your brother, the Prime Minister, is strongly opposed to gay marriage?
Well, he is personally opposed. Mm. He has been quite clear about the fact that he believes that the Marriage Act, as it stands, which defines marriage as being between a man and a woman, should be how it stays, in his opinion. I disagree, respectfully.
Do you think that's because of his Catholic training?
No, I think it's his belief. It might come from his Catholic training, but I was brought up a Catholic.
I was brought up a Catholic too.
And I've cast that off. not necessarily my Catholicism, but I've cast off my belief that marriage has to be a man and a woman.
I blame being an altar boy being like this.
I might bring Senator Wong in now. Senator Wong, as leader of the opposition in the Senate and being openly gay yourself, you've certainly made your view on homophobia well known, but where do you stand on marriage equality in Australia?
Oh, well, pretty obviously, I think I believe in marriage equality. I think, you know, a society that doesn't grant equal rights to its citizens is really not doing the right thing by us all. I don't understand why it's such a problem for everybody else, whether or not I get married or Christine gets married. I don't see why that's an issue for Tony Abbott or others who oppose it. So, you know, I think Australians have moved on. If you think about what's happened over the last 10 years, the reality is the community's way ahead of the parliament on this issue and certainly ahead of the current Prime Minister.
I think you're so right there, Senator Wong. In a same-sex relationship, you're expecting your second child. She's due in April, which is so exciting. How important is it for you to have your relationship legally recognised under the Federal Marriage Act?
Oh, it is important to us and very important to me. And Sophie eventually, I think, got to the same place. took a little convincing. But I think for the same reasons everyone else wants to get married. It's, you know, the public affirmation of your love and commitment for someone and a celebration of that. And also our daughter Alexandra really wants to wear a long dress, so...
Penny, Christine, you're both in political areas. You both could lobby. I mean, do you both do a lot of lobbying? Because really, at the end of the day, the whole issue of gay marriage is something to do. It's to do with the party room and the parliament. I mean, do you spend a lot of time talking to your colleagues? How optimistic are both of you that this might finally get up sooner rather than later? Penny?
Well,
first?
I'll go first. I did. Labor used to have a position which I didn't agree with, and a lot of us worked very hard to change that position at the national conference. And I'm really grateful to the people in the community who helped us do that. Ultimately, the thing that's preventing us getting marriage equality is the Liberal Party and Tony Abbott refusing a genuine conscience vote. And I think what we have to get is a genuine conscience vote across the Parliament. And then what we need to do is make sure that we lobby all of us, press people on both sides of politics, including those in the Liberal Party, to support equality, because we need this to... This will only ever pass if there's bipartisanship and a lot of bipartisanship, so we get a lot of people from both sides of politics backing this in.
Yeah, well, Penny's quite right. We do need a conscience vote across the Parliament. The Prime Minister was very clear before the last election that it would be a matter for discussion in the Liberal National Party room when it if and when it came up in the Parliament. It hasn't come up as yet. Senator Layenhelm has flagged, well, he's tabled a private member's bill, but it hasn't been debated. It hasn't been raised within the party room. I mean, I personally am very hopeful. I'm an optimist that that there will be a conscience vote in the Liberal National Party room. Certainly, my Liberal colleagues that I have discussions with all the time tell me that they are supportive of that, and I just hope that that is a very loud clamour in the party room when it does come up for discussion, because, you know, it should happen.
And just quickly, I agree, Christine. And just quickly, Tony Abbott, you have said, it was one of the strongest bedrocks for you when you were coming out.
Absolutely.
He was incredibly supportive. Yeah. We all know, though, his official sort of public position, if you like, on gay marriage is against it. When you're sort of talking to him about these things, how does he respond? Do you ever just say, for the love of God, Tony, I'm your sister, just let me get married?
I say, for the love of God, Tony, blah, 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 about a lot of things, but as brothers and sisters tend to. But, look, I guess we have just come to a respectful, you know, disagreement on this particular. There's no point me, you know, bashing my head against that brick wall and vice versa. You know, it's just a respectful disagreement. And you know, in many ways, I think my family is a microcosm of Australian society in lots of ways. Less so because obviously that, you know, increasingly, average Australians very much accept the idea of marriage.
I was going to put it another way. I think it's an old boys' club. Mm. And I just don't think they've got out of that old boys' club. Yeah. And that's what I think.
Look, I think it's 2015 and we need to move on this pretty quickly. Christine Forster and Senator Wong, thank you very much for joining us and discussing.
Yeah. Great to be with you.
Thank you.